Hello, Bishop Wooden here. I pray that you're having a wonderful day. I tell you, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Before I talk about tonight's service, I want to give a deep shout out, a word of thanks, a word of appreciation for the just overwhelming love and response and texts, emails, social media greetings that have come from you concerning my birthday. Today is my birthday. I'm proud to say that the Lord in his goodness have allowed me as of today to live 58 years. And I thank God for being alive and well and in the land of the living. And I thank the Lord that of my 58 years, I have been serving the God of the Bible since I was 16 years old. The Lord saved me in 1977. And here we are in 2019, and we're walking with Jesus and enjoying the trip. But for you to take the time to acknowledge me says something wonderful, wonderful about you. Your lives are busy. Your pace are fast. You have 10,000 things to do at any given time, and that you would take the time to remember your servant. I am just touched, and I thank every one of you for the wonderful greetings, the wonderful cards, the wonderful gifts, the texts, the shout outs, the things that you have done to say to me, happy birthday, live on, carry on, man of God. It's overwhelming. I thank God for my staff here who took me out on yesterday. My lovely wife who has been there for me ever since we've been married and doing things to make things special. My family, my son, my daughter, my son-in-law, my grandkids. Oh, and listen, one of the biggest blessings of them all, as many of you know who have been following the ministry, my mother has been ill. But God, in his goodness and in his kindness, has blessed me at this 58th birthday to still have my lovely mama in the land of the living, and mom's doing good. And I'm so grateful to God for that. You know, that's gift enough. The truth is, The biggest gift that is given, the biggest recipient for anyone on their birthday is them, because you show up. You're still alive, and the biggest giver is the Lord who gives us life. So I just want to say to you, thank you so much for your kindness, for all of the kind and supportive things that have been said and done. And I'll be honest with you, it's quite overwhelming that people would be so kind. I'm just touched, and I want to say to you, thank you. Now, having said that, every 7 years, the birthday falls on the church night. And you know what I've been doing on my birthday, my 58th birthday? I've spent the day doing what I was born to do. And that is to dig into the scripture and get ready to teach and preach the word of God. And tonight I'm excited about our Bible study. I want you to come. Bring your word. Bring your Bibles. We are going to study the word of the Lord together. Now, saints, I'll tell you something. I'm going to give away just a little bit of what I'm talking about. Press your way. Do what you have to do to be in service, because the truth is, it takes effort. It takes effort to grow in grace. It takes effort to serve the Lord. It takes effort to succeed in business. It takes effort to maintain a happy marriage. It takes effort to keep your weight down, or to, if you're having problems gaining weight, to get your weight up. It takes effort to do anything that's worthwhile. You have to put your shoulder to the plow. Well, tonight we're going to be talking about this and how we serve a God who rewards us and blesses us as we put forth the effort to be that man or that woman of God that the Lord would have us to be. Again, thank you so much for all of your kind words and the kind texts and phone calls. One preacher called me, and I didn't even recognize his voice at the time. He said, "Hey, friend," and I was so blessed to hear from him. Listen, I love every one of you. I thank you for your being so kind. You know, Gary, I tell people don't have to be kind. People don't have to remember you. People don't have to support you. People don't have to do anything. It takes the God of the Bible, I believe, to put you in people's hearts. And my prayer is, to be honest with you, that I'm able to live up to and to reward your confidence in me with the word of the Lord, a godly life, and being a good representative of the kingdom of God. So pray for me that I continue to walk and to serve the God of the Bible, that we continue to fight the good fight of faith. Hey, you see my flag over there, don't you? Jesus Pride Month is gone, the month of June. But you know what? I said that every month is Jesus Pride Month. So my flag over across my shoulder here, you'll be seeing it. And we got something coming up in October, and I'll talk to you about it later. So we'll see you tonight as we study the word of the Lord together. God bless you. Thank you so much.